Motor racing is probably the most expensive sport to participate in. In recent years, some Formula One teams have run budgets in excess of $400 million. In Top Fuel drag racing, a single run will set you back $3,000. That's for around 5 seconds of race time. So imagine a series where the budget cap is just $1,000.
We started the San Diego Grand Challenge as basically the event that I wished existed. It's a down economy. A lot of people are giving up their weekend racing. So I came up with this crazy idea to put together some junkyard cars or go rescue that old beater in the neighbor's yard and do it for $1,000 or less.
They inadvertently built this series for me. I've been the world's cheapest race driver my entire life.
It is very cheap, and it's a fun way to go racing, and it's a way that you can have good competition without having to spend a ton of money. The $1,000 budget is the rule that makes it even.
In its inaugural season, the San Diego Grand Challenge attracted 15 entrants from a wide range of backgrounds in Southern California, and with a variety of vehicles.
This car is a 1967 Volkswagen Bug. The car was sitting on a trailer in my backyard for 17 years, the last time I used it.
It's a 72 Datsun 240Z. We bought this car for $50. Doesn't look like it, but when we first bought the car, it had holes like this big on all sides of the car. And the floor pan was like there wasn't really a floor pan.
This is an 89 BMW 325i. We bought the car for $500. We spent money on fabricating the roll cage from scratch and some racing seats. But other than that, the car is mostly as we bought it.
Importantly, tires are not included in the $1,000 rule. Instead, everyone must use the same street tires. With events on both an 8-mile drag strip and an autocross slalom course, the cars are properly put to the test for handling and straight-line acceleration.
We knew that the Volkswagen, with the weight over the rear wheels, would launch in drag racing, and especially in 8-mile drags. We stand a good chance of launching ahead of every other car. Whether we beat them to the end or not, that's another story. But the series requires that we run on 200 treadwear street tires. You really find out how archaic a 42-year-old swing axle suspension is when you try to make it go around corners, basically, on street tires.
Mechanical knowledge and hard work completely replaced the checkbook in this series. Full-time mechanic Jason Goen even resurrected an old turbo to run his Datsun 240Z for the drag events and came up with an innovative solution to improve the setup for the autocross.
Camber was positive camber. It was actually really bad for autocrossing. So we had to drill holes in our subframe, new holes, and move the lower control arms out to get more camber. You have to spend a lot of time and effort to make a small change, whereas you could just go to the parts store. Here's $100. I want a camber kit. Just install it. Takes a few minutes. No, we gotta spend hours and hours and lots of planning and fabricating and cross your fingers, see if it works.
After 7 events, the Screaming Yellow Zonkers and Team Kart were tied for the lead in the title race. But there is no doubt at all that everybody got their money's worth.
It's all about love of the sport. Money doesn't matter. You can't buy your way to victory here. You have to work your way to it. We're testing mechanical skill, ingenuity. We're testing your ability to scrounge parts out of the junkyard. That hard limit of budget really takes the check wrench, as they call it, out of the equation. It's just mano a mano.